Hello and welcome to the graduation of the ROC class of 2020. My friend Kathy will escort you to your seat.
Come with me. Here's your seat and a copy of your own program. I hope you enjoy the graduation.
Student Council President Jacob Gilio. This has been a tough time for our school, for our town, and for our country. While many in our community have had to face the difficult adjustments of living in social distancing, A brave few have had to continue to face danger each and every day. To fight on the front line against the COVID-19 virus. The sacrifices of each of these essential workers will never be forgotten and deserves to be honored. So, at this time, I would like to ask each of the members of the audience, regardless of where you are, to please stand and join some of our parents who just happened to be heroes. Yvonne Hubero, Matthew Giglio, Danielle Lena, in the saying of the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America
and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Thank you to all of our essential workers throughout our country and throughout our world. Please continue to stand as we join two of my classmates, Danielle Castro and Emma Rivas, as we honor America and sing our national anthem.
And bright stars through the perilous fight. Over the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Good evening, fellow graduates, friends, family, and staff of the Robert L. Craig Class of 2020. My name is Pernee Kaur, and I am the salutatorian for the Class of 2020. It is such an honor to deliver this year's salutatorian speech. It is unfortunate that this year's graduation ceremony is being conducted virtually. This is, of course, not how we imagined our grade school experiences to end. Even though we are not together in person, we are together within our hearts, regardless of wherever we are. And we will remain connected throughout our lives because of our experiences at Robert L. Craig School. First, I would like to thank all of you, from teachers to friends and family, for being in attendance this evening. You have all had a profound impact on the development of the class that will be graduating today, and I feel safe to say that I'm speaking for the whole graduating class of 2020 and thanking you for all your efforts that you've invested in us to this day. When I first sat down to write this speech, tons of thoughts were flowing through my mind. Am I going to reminisce about memories of great importance to me? How about speaking of significant events for the entire school? What message should I try to convey? I decided to set my goal for this speech to be something different. We are having a very unique graduation ceremony after all. However, it is more so about your accomplishments and how this speech could craft inspiration and motivate all of you. Never hesitate to recognize how proud each and every person here today is for you to have made it this far. It's hard to ignore the determination, perseverance, patience, hard work, and even sacrifice that embodies each and every graduate. There will be many more challenges to face in the future, and I know each and every one of you will handle them with dignity. I'm also filled with anticipation because I have no doubt in my mind that each one of you sitting before me has the potential to succeed and make a difference in life. Not every one of us can be rich, famous, or powerful, but oftentimes it is the words of advice and encouragement that make a difference in the world. A special thank you to Mrs. Monty and Ms. Scheuer for being the best possible class parents any of us could have asked for. You each have done so much throughout our time at RLC. Your time, your creativity, your devotion are truly appreciated. Each of us owes you a debt of thanks. So on behalf of my fellow graduates, thank you. I want to thank Mr. Keelan for putting together an exemplary virtual graduation for us in these circumstances. A special thank you to our middle school teachers, including Ms. DeSica, Ms. Trouse, Ms. Perez, Ms. Kenny, Mr. Alonzo, and Mr. Keelan, for teaching us many things that will be useful not only now, but in the future. Special thank you to all of our specials teachers, some who have been teaching us since kindergarten. A huge thanks to Dr. Pons for always encouraging us to do our best. And thank you to Mr. Nipper, who always believed in us. As Maya Angelou said, the horizon leans forward, offering you space for steps of change. I truly believe that each and every one of you has the potential to make a difference in life. The memories that we made together shape each and every one of us into the people we are today. The Robert L. Craig Class of 2020 will always be a special one.
Greetings to the graduation ceremony for the Class of 2020. Now for our awards. Presenting the Board of Education Award is our Board Vice President, Mr. James Campbell.
On behalf of the Moonachie Board of Education, I would like to congratulate the Class of 2020 and their families. Third honors, Zachary G. McAlenta.
Thank you to Vice President Campbell and the Moonachie Board of Education for this honor.
Second honors, Harneet Kaur.
Thank you to Vice President Campbell and the Moonachie Board of Education for this honor.
First honors, Misha C. Panchal.
Thank you, Vice President Campbell and the Moonachie Board of Education for this honor.
Thank you, good night, and God bless you all.
Presenting the PTO Award is our PTO President, Mrs. Ayers.
PTO President Adriana Ayers. On behalf of the PTO, I would like to send congratulations to the 8th grade graduates. I'm here to present the 4th place honors award to Santiago Roballo.
Thank you, Mrs. Ayers, and thank you, RLC PTO, for this honor and for doing so much to support the Class of 2020.
The 5th place honors award to David Sarmiento Arias.
Thank you, Mrs. Ayers, and thank you to the RLC PTO for this award and always supporting the students of our school.
As well as a 6th place honors award to Karen Peralta Mendiola.
Thank you, Ms. Ayers, and thank you for the RLC PTO for this honor and for your hard work and kindness.
Good luck to the recipients and the Class of 2020 on their future endeavors. Thank you.
Presenting the Mayor Award is the Honorable Dennis Vaccaro.
Good afternoon, this is Mayor Dennis Vaccaro. First, I want to congratulate the family members, but more importantly, I want to congratulate all the graduates of 2020. This is a tough time this year, but I'm happy that you let me be a part of it. So, the Mayor's Award, first honor goes to Misha Panchal. So, congratulations, Misha, and thank you.
Thank you, Mayor Vaccaro and the Moonachie Borough Council for this honor.
Presenting the Moonachie Education Association Award is Mr. Frisch.
Hello, my name is Joshua Frisch. I am the technology teacher at Robert L. Craig School. I am also the treasurer of the Moonachie Education Association. On behalf of the Moonachie Education Association, I want to congratulate the Class of 2020 on their graduation of 8th grade. We will miss you dearly. You are a pleasure to teach and be around, and we wish you the best of luck in your next school. I'm here to present second and third honors. Second honors goes to Parneet Kaur.
Thank you to Mr. Frisch and the Moonachie Education Association for this honor.
And third honors goes to Zachary McAlintal.
Thank you to Mr. Frisch and the Moonachie Education Association for this honor.
Congratulations to both of you. And again, congratulations to the Class of 2020.
Presenting the Virginia Bernhardt Memorial Award is Councilwoman Kathy Kinsella.
Each year, the Moonachie Athletic Association presents awards to students who have continued in the MAA programs and who have displayed excellence in athletics and sportsmanship. I am happy to present the Virginia Burkhardt Award to Daniel Castro.
I would like to thank the Moonachie Athletics Association and Ms. Kinsella for giving me the Virginia Burkhardt Award.
And Brian Harrisack.
I'd like to thank Ms. Kinsella for selecting me to receive the Virginia Burkhardt Award to honor all my accomplishments.
Congratulations and good luck in your high school programs.
Presenting the Moonachie Senior Club Award is President and Board Member Mr. Charles Palace.
Every year, the Moonachie Senior Club is proud to present a check of $100 to the winner of the Writers Award. The name isn't just picked out of a hat. The student earned it, and the recipient is Jacob Giglio.
Thank you, Mr. Palace, and the great Moonachie Senior Citizen Club for this honor. You have my deepest appreciation.
Congratulations.
Presenting the Moonachie Democrat Club Award is Councilwoman Kathy Kinsella.
On behalf of the Democratic Club, congratulations to the class of 2020. Continue to follow your dreams, and may all your wishes come true. It is my pleasure to present this award for excellence in science to one of my favorite students since way back in the second grade. I am so proud of the young man you have become. The award is presented to Jacob Giglio. Congratulations.
Thank you for granting me these awards and supporting our 8th grade graduation. It means a lot that there are still people out there, even through this hard time, supporting our graduations and showing us the kindness that this world needs. Thank you, and I will always remember you.
Presenting the Moonachie Police Award is Chief Richard Behrens.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sergeant Victor Miglerino of the Moonachie Police Department. On behalf of Police Chief Richard Behrens and the entire Moonachie Police Department, I would like to give my most sincere congratulations to the Robert L. Craig School Class of 2020. It is my pleasure to announce to you the recipient of the Moonachie Police Award for Technology for the Class of 2020 is being awarded to Krishna Patel. Congratulations, Krishna. Again, to all the graduates, good luck with all your future endeavors. And remember, to stay safe, I hope to see you all in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief Behrens and to the Moonachie Police Department for this generous award and for all you do to keep this community safe.
Presenting the Moonachie First Aid Squad Award is Captain Frank Smith.
Hello, Class of 2020. My name is Frank Smith. I'm Captain of the Moonachie First Aid and Rescue Squad. It is my honor to give this year's health award out to Anissa, Mia, Lena. Congratulations. You guys enjoy your graduation and stay safe.
Thank you to Captain Smith and to the Moonachie First Aid Squad for this honor. And thank you for all you have done as first responders for our community.
Presenting the Ed G. Tarani Memorial Scholarship Award is Mr. Keelan.
Hello, I'm 8th grade advisor Mr. Keelan. And it is my honor to present the Edward G. Tarani Award on behalf of the Tarani family. Edward G. Tarani served the RLC community for decades, both as a teacher and an administrator. Our gym is named after him. His family established this award to honor a student who exemplifies excellence in both academics and athletics. I am proud to announce that the recipient of the Edward G. Tarani Award for the Class of 2020 is a young man who displays superior athleticism on a soccer field where he has played as a defender at the travel level for more than 10 years. He also has represented himself as an outstanding scholar, consistently being on the honor roll and being selected for the inaugural chapter of the Robert L. Craig School National Junior Honor Society. Congratulations to Dominic Monti.
Thank you, Mr. Keelan, and thank you to the Tarragani family for giving me this scholarship in honor of Edward G. Tarragani.
Presenting the Eileen Keller Memorial Humanitarian Award is Miss Lynn Hernandez.
Congratulations, Class of 2020. My name is Lynn Hernandez, and I am here to present the Humanitarian Award in memory of my mother, Eileen Keller. For anyone who knew my mother, knew that she was the epitome of a true humanitarian. She was conscious of circumstances of other people's lives and helping them on the basis of need without discrimination. Therefore, it is my privilege and honor to present this year's humanitarian award to Misha Panchel. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ms. Hernandez, for this scholarship in your mother's memory.
Presenting the South Bergen Rotary Award is Miss Mary Ellen Lyons.
Hi, I'm Mary Ellen Lyons. I'm the president of the South Bergen Rotary Club, and we have a partnership with your school. Today, or tonight, depending on when you see this, I am here to present four awards from our club. The first award is the South Bergen Rotary All Around Student Award, and that goes to Santiago Robayo. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ms. Lyons, and thank you to the South Bergen Rotary for this honor and always being there for RLC.
The second award is the South Bergen Rotary Community Spirit Award, and that goes to Angelica Cassetta. Congratulations, Angelica.
Thank you, Ms. Lyons, and thank you to the South Bergen Rotary Club for this honor and always coming through for our school.
The History and Civics Award goes to Anissa Mia Lena, and we're very happy to give it to you. Congratulations, best of luck.
Thank you to Ms. Lyons and to the South Bergen Rotary for your generosity to me and my community.
And finally, the Math Award goes to Zachary McAlental, and we wish you the best of luck as well.
Thank you, Ms. Lyons, and thank you, South Bergen Rotary, for this award and for all you do for our community.
The club wants to tell all of you how proud we are of how well you've weathered the new learning environment since March, and we know you're going to have a wonderful summer. We hope you have the best of luck, the best of health, and a very good future. Thank you.
Presenting the Margie's Deli Music Award is Miss Kimberly Smith.
Hello. I'm Ms. Kimberly Schmidt, the music teacher here at RLC. I would like to thank Margie's Deli for their contribution and continued support of our students. I would also like to take this time to congratulate the class of 2020. I want to wish them good luck on all their future endeavors, and please know that you will be dearly missed. The award I am presenting is Margie's Music Award. This award is going to Stephanie Angeli Gonzalez. Congratulations.
And thank you to Ralph Shadow and the staff of Margie's Deli for this honor.
Mwah. Presenting the Robert L. Craig Art Awards is Miss Lee Tenhove.
Hi, my name is Lee Tenhove and I'm the art teacher at the Robert L. Craig School. First, I'd like to congratulate the class of 2020. It's been a sincere pleasure to teach you and to know you all of these years. Although you are moving on, know that you've left your mark here at RLC. And remember, life is like a painting. Make yours a masterpiece. I am honored today to be presenting two art awards to two incredible students. And these two students consistently challenge themselves to produce work of the highest caliber while also demonstrating tremendous creativity, ingenuity, and skill. So the two recipients of the 2020 Art Award are Jerry Rivera and Parneet Kaur. Congratulations, guys.
Ms. Tenhove and Dr. Ponce for this honor.
Thank you to Ms. Tenhove and Dr. Ponce for the Art Award.
Presenting the Robert L. Craig Spanish Awards is Ms. Blanca Diaz.
Good evening. For those who don't know me, my name is Blanca Diaz and I am the Spanish and ESL teacher of the school. Buenas noches, para los que no me conocen, mi nombre es Blanca Diaz y yo soy la maestra de español y de ESL de la escuela. Tonight, I have the honor to present the Spanish Award. Esta noche tengo el honor de presentar el premio de español. And the award goes to Jerry Rivera and Yemabel Sánchez Cano. Thank you.
Gracias, señora Diaz and Dr. Pons, for the Spanish Award.
Blanca, for this amazing award. I will always appreciate you and miss you. I wish the best to you and thank you for everything.
Presenting the Bistro 107 Cucicini. Italiani Citizenship Award is Mr. Greg Keelan.
Hello, I'm RLC History and Civics teacher and 8th grade advisor, Greg Keelan, and it is my honor to present the Bistro 107 Cucina Italiana Citizenship Award. First, I'd like to extend my deepest thanks to Rich Vukoc and the staff of Bistro 107 for their support of the class of 2020 and the Moonachie community. You have our deepest appreciation. And I'd also like to give my sincerest congratulations to the RLC class of 2020. You're one for the ages. I am proud to announce that the recipient of the Bistro 107 Cucina Italiana Citizenship Award for the class of 2020 is a young woman who could always be counted on to treat everyone with kindness and who is always ready to make a difference. Maria Garces Alzate. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Vukoc and the Bistro 107 for this honor.
Presenting in the honor of Charles R. Palace and in the memory of May Palace, the Most Improved ELA Award is Miss Barbara D'Attentito.
My brother and I set up the next two awards to honor and show gratitude for our father and mother, Charles and May Palace, for all they have done over the past 6 decades for the children of Moonachie. Our mother was meticulous when it came to writing and the use of the English language. Every I had to be dotted and every T had to be crossed. She was fastidious when it came to sentence structure. She helped set up Title I in Moonachie when she was the secretary to the board. So in memory of our mother, we would like to present to the recipient of this year's award for the Most Improved Student in English and Language Arts, to Zachary Velez. Congratulations, Zachary. You deserve it.
Thank you, Mrs. D'Attentito, for this award in honor of your father and the memory of your mother.
In the honor of Charles R. Palace, in the memory of May Palace, presenting the Most Improved Math Award is Miss Barbara D'Attentito.
When our dad was a young boy, his father passed away. His mother raised 3 active boys by herself. He grew up in the tenements in the Bronx. When his 2 brothers were called to serve in World War II, he stayed behind and worked while going to college and supporting his mom. Within a year, he was called up to serve. Upon his return, he was able to return to college on the GI Bill and get a degree in accounting. He worked diligently to improve his position so he was able to get a better job, a better salary, and so he could give his wife and children a better living situation than what he grew up with. Our dad has dedicated more than 60 years serving the citizens of Moonachie. He has assisted in making great strides to have so many programs implemented over the years. His number one objective is to give each and every student the opportunity to be the best they can be by making sure they are getting the best education possible. So in honor of our dad, we would like to present to the recipient of this year's award for the Most Improved Student in Mathematics, to Jerry Rivera. Congratulations, Jerry. Keep up the good work.
Thank you, Ms. D'Attentito, for this award in honor of your father and in memory of your mother. Thank you for helping our school.
Please listen to our special guest give a speech, our Senator Cory Booker.
It's Cory Booker, the senator from our great state of New Jersey. And I wanted to record a message for all of our 8th grade graduates here in our great Garden State. And I am grateful, first and foremost, to the whole community that made this important graduation possible. From parents to teachers, faculty, staff, administrators, custodial staff, people working in cafeterias. It took so many people working together to support our young folks to get to this great graduation. And to the class of 2020, your grit and your goodness Your struggle and even sacrifice that made this day possible, it is laying a foundation for you for an incredible high school experience. You all are actually a part of my unconquerable faith in our future. I believe in you and all the infinite possibilities that you have for your journey, and I congratulate you. I celebrate you. I am deeply proud of you and how you're making us, through your work, you're making us even more Jersey strong.
Greetings, family, friends, faculty, and graduates. Graduates, this is a moment you should all be proud of. You have all accomplished so much in a short period of time. You have weathered and are weathering the storms of uncertainty. As you ask yourself, how do I move forward? How do I face my new challenges? I tell you, be not afraid. You have the foundation to meet each challenge. Be not afraid. You have the fortitude. Be not afraid. You have the resiliency. Be not afraid. You are loved. Be not afraid because you are determined. Yes, be not afraid because you're going to do what some people say is the impossible. I will give you this quote. The difference between the impossible and the possible lies between a person's determination. Class of 2020, you are determined. Be not afraid, class of 2020, because your future is bright. I will end this like I start every day. Always do your best, and that you are special. Mr. Vaquero, having met the requirements of the Moonachie Board of Education and the state of New Jersey, it is my pleasure to present the graduating class of 2020. I would like now to invite the board president, Mr. David Vaquero, to address the graduates.
Good evening, class of 2020. My name is Dave Vaquero. I'm the Moonachie Board of Education president. Welcome, parents, and most of all, welcome, students. Congratulations, you did it. You've made it. I know this is not the graduation ceremony that you and your family envisioned, but that doesn't change the hard work and sacrifices that you made to achieve this milestone. I'm sure this last 2 months, not what you're used to, the way you wanted to end your eighth grade, but we're in a different place today. Remember, this is a day of celebration. Keep in mind what's in front of you. Moving up to high school, new beginnings and new ventures. Embrace it, enjoy it. It will go fast. Get involved, make new friends that will last forever. And just think, you might be taking part in one of the only virtual graduations that they'll ever have. Congratulations, good luck. Thank you.
This is it, eighth grade.
Wow, all of these years in the school and we finally made it.
I can't wait. I had to watch everyone get through eighth grade. It's finally our chance.
I don't know what I'm more excited about.
I'm so pumped for DC. I can't wait to see the White House.
And we all worked to make sure that none of us even had to pay.
Ah, the hotel room? I can't wait.
I'm excited for the dance. I have a perfect dress picked out.
Me too. Y'all know I got the moves.
How about student day? I want to be the principal.
What I'm really excited for is graduation and being on the stage with my whole family there.
I know it's going to be the best year ever.
Good evening, I'm Kelly Evans.
I'm Scott Wapner. This is the 63rd day of this massive global health crisis.
Yeah, we are here tonight because of the violent market reaction to the very real threat the coronavirus is about to impact this country in ways we have never seen before.
Many schools around the world, as you know, have shut down, some for extended periods of time, as this virus spreads. In the U.S., some schools in 7 states have temporarily closed as a precaution.
Stay home and keep your distance.
The advice is getting stronger.
The United States has largely been on pause in the midst of the coronavirus outbreak, but many Americans have been working out and about, and some are even in close contact with people infected with COVID-19. Health officials have issued new recommendations for those whose lives could potentially be in danger.
Take their temperature before they go to work,
wear our face mask at all times.
Today we are announcing that all New Jersey school buildings will remain closed for in-person instruction for the remainder of the 2019-2020 school year, and that all students and faculty will continue with remote learning.
The class of 2020 won't be defined by what we lost to this virus, but by how we responded to it. The world is yours now, and I can't wait to see what you make of it.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Back home. Ah, on the street. are getting older, but there's so much we haven't done yet. Some days I'm not here, I don't get dressed, and I curse my bedroom, but I left it all along. Cause all this time I'm runaway, 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 runaway gone. And everyone is changing, I start from rearranging. I picked up a quarter and I just saw my face. But it's all coming back now, and the feeling isn't over. Hey, I know I was lost, but I miss those days. I said la 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 la, lost, but I miss those days. Well, I'm talking now. Sitting on my sister's rooftop, watching our city burn into the night. I'm not sure that we were meant to survive. I was 16 in a van, driving myself to Florida. Part of me never left that seat, cause nights and weekends still looking for a dream.
Difficult to stand, but hold your balance. I just say whatever, cause there is no way you're round it. Cause everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Hey, feeling good, like I should. When in Durga, walk around the neighborhood, feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Hey, someday days you wake up and nothing works, you feel surrounded. Gotta give your feet some gravity to get you grounded. Keep good things inside your ears just like the waves and sound it. And just say whatever, cause there is no way you're grounded. Everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay. It's okay, it's okay. Hey, feeling good, like I should. When in dark, I walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Hey, feeling good, like I should. When in dark, I walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best.
I want to say thank you to Ms. Trouse for always having patience with me. I want to say thank you to all the RLC staff for helping me.
Thank you to God and my parents and my teachers for helping me graduate today.
My family and all my teachers.
I'd like to say thank you to Coach Ed Monty, Coach Joseph Gingerelli, and Coach Kenny for being here with me through these years and helping me with my athletics.
Thank you, Ms. Kenny, for motivating us to learn and respect in your classroom and to show us the cool aspects of science.
I want to thank Ms. Gallo, Ms. Paniello, and Ms. Nidia for helping me out through school.
First, I want to thank my family because without them, I wouldn't be here. Secondly, I want to thank all my teachers and Ms. Baniello because she helped me during the school. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dad, for getting me through the school year, feeding me, clothing me, giving me somewhere to sleep, and most of all, loving me, and making sure that I got caught up on all my schoolwork so I would be able to have an amazing future. Thank you, and I love you.
I want to thank all my teachers out there, especially Ms. Boyan, you know what I'm saying? Thank you guys for helping me out. I also want to thank my parents for helping me out, always being there. And yeah, I miss you guys.
I want to say thank you to all the teachers, especially Ms. Perez, Ms. Gato, Ms. Strauss, Ms. Sistika, Mr. Alonso, everybody, Mr. Keelan, Ms. Kenny, everybody for helping me learn and stuff. And I wouldn't be here without you guys, so thank you so much for teaching me, and I think I'm smarter now.
I would like to thank my mom, all the class parents, and my friends, and the teachers for making my time at Robert L. Craig wonderful.
Alright, so I'm thankful for my mom for always supporting me, and also thank you for my grandma for always being there also.
Thank you to all my teachers who've ensured my educational success. And thank you to my family for supporting me in everything.
Besides my wonderful family and friends, I'd like to take a moment to appreciate and thank Mr. Keelan for teaching me all of the valuable lessons during his classroom and outside of his classroom. And for being an awesome teacher with musical information. Back on, Mr. Keelan. Thank you.
I want to thank my parents, my siblings, my family and friends, and I also want to thank my teachers.
I just want to say thank you to my mom and my dad and all my teachers for helping me.
I would like to thank all of my friends and family for letting me be who I am today. And then I would especially like to thank Ms. Perez for teaching me more about writing and reading and etc.
I'd like to thank my parents, my teachers, especially Ms. Perez and Ms. Boniello for always looking out for me and helping with work. And also Mr. Keelan, being the best teacher ever.
Thank you to all my teachers, Dr. Pons and Mr. Nipper, and my family for supporting me in my educational journey and for having a profound impact in my life.
I would like to thank all my teachers for getting me where I am today. And thank you especially to my family for always supporting me.
I would like to thank my parents and especially my mom for helping me with my schoolwork and my projects.
All my teachers that have taught me throughout the year and virtually. A special thanks to Mr. Kidman, who have allowed to move this virtual graduation to happen.
Lastly, I'd like to give a thanks to my family, my friends, as they have been the ones supporting me throughout my academic journey.
So thank you to all the teachers for teaching me everything I know now. And I also want to give thanks to my dad for always encouraging me to wake up in the morning and go to school. Because if it wasn't for him, I probably wouldn't have gone.
Thank my family, my friends, and the teachers that were with me throughout my 8 years of being in Robert L. Craig School, and how they always have helped me throughout the year.
I want to thank my parents and all of my family for everything they've done for me, and especially my teachers, who truly made my school experience the best it could be.
Thank you to all the teachers that supported me, and thank you to all the class parents that made this all possible. Also, thank you to my family.
I want to say thank you to Ms. Perez for never letting me give up and always pushing me to do my best.
Thank God for giving me this opportunity to finish the school year. I also want to thank my parents and Mr. Nipper, Dr. Ponce, and all the teachers for making this year the best. I also want to thank my friends for always being there for me. And I want to thank the class parents for always helping the class. Thank you.
I would like to thank God for surrounding me with such amazing people who shaped the person I am today and the person I will become. I would especially like to thank my mom and dad for always being there and guiding me through these years. I would also like to thank my family and friends for making me a better person.
I'd like to thank all my teachers for helping me get through the school year. And I'd like to thank my parents for helping me and support me, getting me through to graduate. I'm gonna miss you all. Thank you.
To mom, all the faculty and staff, and also dad, you'll always be on our memories.
I want to thank my family for giving me the opportunity to apply to many of the schools and helping me out through the year. I want to thank Dr. Bonds and Mr. Nipper and the teachers from pre-K and up to 8th grade for doing everything for me and getting me up to this point.
Don't you Victor Caceres, Alexis Carlillo, Angelica Cassetta, Daniel Enrique Castro, Joanna Chimbe, Rose Nelly Florencio, Maria Paulina Garces Alzate, Jacob Giglio, Stephanie Angeli Gonzalez, Diana Esmerlin Grullon Alcantara.
Thank you.
Brian Harrisek, Samuel Inouye, Parneet Kaur, Anissa Mia Lena, Zachary G. McAlintel, Dominic Monti, Pedro L. Olivares, Eric O'Neill, Misha C. Panchal, Andrew Pantoja, Krishna Patel, Karen Peralta Mendiola Lisbeth,
congratulations, Karen Peralta.
Michael Perez, Valeria Perez, Emma Yees, Penelope Rivas,
I'm so proud.
Jerry Rivera,
Jerry.
Santiago Robayo, Xavier K. Rozon,
yeah,
Kaylee Erica Sakoto, Jimabel Sanchez Cano, David Sarmiento Arias, Ariana Silva, Zachary Velez. Jason Zero.
When a child says hello to a neighbor
and knows everyone as a friend,
where your feelings are true.
And we've always come through
again.
Take a walk sometimes, look around you.
You're going to like what you find.
People working real hard.
Going one extra yard.
Time after time.
Moonachie is the place.
You were a kind, familiar faces there to greet me.
Where the old and young can live and grow.
And feel as though they're one big family.
M-O-O-N-A-C-H-I-E.
M-O-O-N-A-C-H-I-E.
It's the quiet of a Sunday.
And the 9 to the 5 rush of the week.
Proud growing up.
I'm living a life where there's something of value to keep.
Moonachie is the place.
Where in kind, familiar faces there to greet me. I'm sending that wind.
Where the young and old can live and grow.
And feel as though they're one big family.
M-O-O-N-A-C-H-I-E.
M-O-O-N-A-C-H-I-E.
When a child says hello to a neighbor.
And knows everyone as a friend.
Where our feelings are true.
And we've always come through. Again and again.
And Moonachie is the place
where a kind, familiar face is there to greet me.
Where the young and old can live and grow.
And feel as though one family.
M-O-O-N-A-C-H-I-E.
M-O-O-N-A-C-H-I-E.
And Moonachie is the place.
Where a kind, familiar face is there to greet me.
Where the young and the old can live and grow.
And feel as though we're one big family.
M-O-O-N-A-C-H-I-E.
M-O-O-N-A-C-H-I-E.
I've been staring at the edge of the water long as I can remember, never really knowing why.
I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water no matter how hard I try.
Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to a place I know where I cannot go, where I long to be.
The line of the sky, it's the sea, it calls me, and no one knows how far it goes. If the wind in my sail on the sea is behind me, one day I'll
island seems so happy on this island. Everything's by design.
I know everybody on this island has a role on this island, so maybe I can roll with mine.
I can be good, right? I can make a strong, I'm satisfied, I can play along, but the voice inside sticks a different song. What is wrong with me?
See the light that shines, see it's blinding.
but no one knows how deep it goes. And it seems that it's calling out to me, I'm a little naive. And let me know what's beyond that line, what I crossed that line. The line of the sky, you see, it calls me. And no one knows how far it goes. If the wind on the sail on the sea stays behind me, one day I'll know how far I'll go.
Greetings, everybody. And thank you for being a part of the class of 2020's virtual graduation. I am Misha Panchel, and I am honored to stand before you as the valedictorian of this extraordinary class. This graduation day is so special and a unique moment that we will remember and keep close in our hearts. It radiates a message that we have made it through the struggles and hardships we have endured. And we did it through hard work, dedication, motivation, spirit, and positivity. Lao Tzu once said, "A journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step." And this day is a reflection of our growth and journey together, filled with fun and fulfilling memories as students who have attended the Robert L. Craig School. This is also a pathway to the future of our lives and steps into high school and beyond. I am so inspired by each of the students I have spent time with on this journey of creativity and learning. I can't wait to see what they'll achieve in the future because they all make the world a better place and they have the mindset and power to do so in the future. There are so many people that have made a difference in the lives and education of this class. Before I take the time to thank you all, I would like to take a moment to acknowledge all our healthcare workers who have worked so hard to keep us safe and healthy through these challenging times. You truly are essential, and we owe you our deepest thanks. First of all, I would like to thank our School Board of Education and our administrators, Dr. Pons and Mr. Nipper. Thank you for always being there and giving us so many opportunities. You truly make our futures brighter. You make us believe that we can achieve our goals, our dreams, if we put our mind to it. Thank you for making our experience here at Robert L. Craig School so much better in and out of school. Secondly, I would like to thank our family, friends, class parents, and classmates for supporting and loving us through our lowest points, for showing us true altruism. Your time, effort, and energy helped us get back up when we had fallen down and will continue to give us the strength to do so when life gives us even more challenges. Thank you for always being there, no matter what obstacle came our way in this journey. You have impacted our lives forever. A special thanks to all our teachers who have made us who we are today, who have guided us with so much love and wisdom on the pathway of success in our education and our lives. You have done so much and have given us endless compassion and care for what we want to learn, for setting our dreams and goals, and for determining how we want to achieve them. In this time, we have fought through many struggles, but all of us have gotten through it. And I want to give thanks to everyone who has made this situation even more bearable by keeping us safe and continuing our education digitally. I miss all of you and will always, always appreciate you. Now to my family within the class of 2020. We have faced so many challenges that have made our experience here a roller coaster of learning and happiness. Booker T. Washington once observed that success is to be measured not so much by the position that one has reached in life, but by the obstacles which he has overcome. I want to say that in the future, we may face challenges and adversities that are very hard, but growing and changing from the challenges we learn in a positive way can make the world a better place. As Mahatma Gandhi noted, live as if you were to die tomorrow. Learn as if you were to live forever. Live your life to the fullest and appreciate it. Having the opportunity to learn something is so powerful, and you should grasp it, because whether we are learning to never give up in the face of failure or learning a simple math equation, knowledge can do us wonders and lead to the pathway of success and also the pathway to change the world. As Colin Powell pointed out, a dream does not become reality through magic. It takes sweat, determination, and hard work. I also want you to know that you can do anything, achieve anything, and follow your dreams if you put your mind to it by having a positive mindset, working hard, doing the best you can do, and never giving up, because dedication and effort pay off. Class of 2020, we have made it. We have made it through the journey of our lives as we step into more each coming way. I truly want to say thank you for everything you have done to make our lives a better place. Thank you for being family, friends, and classmates. Thank you for your support, love, altruism, determination, passion, and spirit. You all have the power to change the world, because I know you can. And when you put your mind to it and believe you can, you truly can. And to quote Eleanor Roosevelt, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. I love and miss each and every one of you, and I can't wait for you to begin your journey in high school. Our chapter here has not ended, but has grown into a new one, and we will always hold our experience here at Robert L. Craig School closely in our hearts. To end off this amazing event that celebrates our times together, like Dr. Pons would have said, come on everybody, say it with me. Always do your best, and you are special. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce to you, for the first time, the Robert L. Craig School Class of 2020 graduates! Woohoo, we did it!
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shelf and kicked in my face. taken my bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race, and I ain't gonna lose. And I need to go. We are the champions.
Thank you.